Today I'm going to show you how to upgrade your sound for your Raspberry Pi and Arduino projects by repurposing these old Samsung TV speakers with the PAM8610 amplifier board. If you're not familiar with this amplifier board, the PAM8610 amplifier is a small electronic device that can enhance and amplify the audio output of the speakers. And it operates pretty efficiently with a low power consumption. It provides 10 watts of power to each speaker, and today we'll have two, so it'll be a total of 20 watts for two speakers. And it works with a wide frequency range, and it requires a DC power supply between 7.5 volts and 15 volts. However, it is recommended that you use a 12 volt power supply when using this. Here's a diagram of the board, the amplifier board, and I took this right off Amazon's website, and I will provide a link to this on Amazon. If you look at the bottom of the diagram, you can see on the right side there is a power LED light indicator. Next to that is a mute switch and a power switch. That way you can mute your music or turn your power to the board off. We'll hook those up at the end of the video. And up on top you can see that it has an audio input port right next to the DC 12 volt port. And right next to that there is the left and right positive and negative port for the speakers. These speakers came from a Samsung LCD television that was about 15 years old. They are 8 ohm 10 watt speakers. They're fairly small and I think will be good for projects. These speakers were initially connected, but I cut them apart. I don't think I'll reconnect them. I'm going to use them as two separate speakers. One is a tweeter and the other one gives a mid-range sound, so it'll be good for projects. In this setup I used a male and female power connector. This is a 12 volt DC power connector. And I did that because the auxiliary plug and the power plug are pretty close together on the board, as you can see here. And this is a 12 volt power supply. As you can see, it flares out a little bit and it kind of gets in the way of the auxiliary cable. It is a tight fit with the power connector as well, but I think it works a little bit better. Now this is the 3.5 millimeter auxiliary cable, or stereo cable, whatever you want to call it. I always call it auxiliary cable. And we're going to go ahead and put it into the stereo jack, or auxiliary jack, as I like to call it. And as you can see, it's pretty tight fit still, but I mean, it works out. And the other end will fit right into your computer or your audio source. Now it's time to connect the speakers. I'm going to go ahead and connect the left and right speaker with the proper positive and negative port here. Now, if you don't have your own television speakers, you can buy them on eBay that somebody has harvested from an old TV. Or you can buy them brand new as well, the 8 ohm 10 watt speakers, and then use this exact same amplifier board. What I plan to do is put this into a cabinet and use it for projects, see how that goes. I am pretty excited about it because while Samsung doesn't make that great of a kitchen appliance, they make really good phones, TVs, and speakers. Well, there's your look at it. It looks like I could have pushed the leads in a little more on the one speaker, but that's it. Just screw them down. Next, we're going to plug in the power connector. Next, we plug in our audio cable. One end to the board, to the amplifier. The other end goes to the computer. Then we plug in our 12 volt power supply to the amplifier. And now it's on and ready to go. Now we're going to turn the speakers up. It does get pretty loud. You get quite a bit of sound coming through these two speakers. These speakers have a lot of sound, just not a lot of bass. It was vibrating on the desk, so I had to dampen it a little bit with this piece of paper. Now we're going to use the mute connector pins on the top of the board here to set up our mute button. We're going to do that with a two male to female jumper wires and a momentary push button. I'm using a two pin push button here, and you can put the positive and negative on either pin of that push button. Here's a close-up for you, just so you know what it looks like. And when I press the button, it mutes the music, which is nice. But I think there's a better option. Here's a single-pole, double-throw switch. SBDT, and you can turn it on and off. You don't have to hold anything down. And if it's helpful, here's a close-up of that. And once it's set up, you can switch it to mute and leave it and switch it back on. Pretty nice. Now we're going to set up the power switch so we can go ahead and remove that jumper pack over the switch pins. And I'm going to connect some male to female jumper wires here and then connect it to a switch so that I can turn the power to the board on and off. And I'm going to use that same switch, the single pole double throw switch. Here's a close up for you. And when I switch it, it powers the board on. You can see the LED light up. And when I switch it off, you can see the LED, the power LED goes off. So that's a pretty nice option too. Thank you for watching. If it was helpful to you, be sure to like and subscribe and share the video with others. And I'll see you again soon. Thanks.